Dear students, in this lecture, we are going to cover the history of Simon Commission's visit to India and the Indian response, which was basically in form of Nehru Report. So, you would be curious to understand that what was this Simon Commission, why was this boycotted, because this Simon, you can see Simon go back. That means people of India were very much against this Simon Commission. So what was this Simon Commission? What, for what purpose had it come to India? And what is this Nehru Report? So let's see in detail. So what was Simon Commission? The Government of India Act 1919 made a provision for a review committee on its working after 10 years. Now what was this Government of India Act? So from time to time, the Britishers used to pass legislation and they used to say that we are giving more powers to Indians, or you can say we are developing the concept of parliament in India. We are developing parliamentary democracy in India. So one such legislation, historic legislation, was passed in 1919, which is known as GOI, Government of India Act 1919. So in this, diarchy was introduced. Diarchy, that means two houses, two governments. So one is provincial government and one is central government. So diarchy was introduced. So it was also decided in 1919 itself that after 10 years, a committee will be visiting India to analyze what was the impact or how the Indian government machinery is functioning. So this was promised in 1919. So it was expected that one such commission will be visiting India in 1929, because it was promised that 10 years later we are going to come again to understand how things are going on. So it was already expected that one such commission would be coming. So a visit of an inquiry commission was to take place already in 1929. It was expected. However, the Conservative Party in power knew that the Labour Party would win the next elections. So that at, we are talking about the time period 1927-28 when Simon Commission was sent to India. At that time, Conservative Party was in power. But they knew that very soon Labour Party would replace us. Post of Prime Minister would go to Labour Party. So it also meant that the commission which was supposed to come in 1929 would then be sent by Labour Party and not by Conservative Party. But the problem was that this Labour Party was believed to be very sympathetic towards Indians, and they also supported Indian freedom. So this Conservative Party, they thought that this Labour Party, if this Labour Party is allowed to send a commission, we don't know what this Labour Party will do. They may give too much of concession to Indians. So Conservative Party did not want that to happen. So as they did not trust an inexperienced Labour Party, it will be inexperienced. They were not that much experienced. So they sent the inquiry commission 2 years before it was scheduled. Though it was scheduled to come in 1929, but the inquiry commission was sent in 1927 itself. It reached India in 1928, because they used to come through ships. It used to take at least 15-20 days to travel on ship. So they started in 27 itself, but they reached India in 1928. So this is what was Simon Commission. Officially, this commission was known as Indian Statutory Commission. Statutory means made by law. Something which is made by passing a law. So a law was passed and this committee was, or commission was made. This was popularly known as Simon Commission. Its official name is Indian Statutory Commission. That means we have to go to India. We have to talk to Indians and we have to discuss with them that how their country is functioning, what changes do they want in the governmental setup. But this was popularly known as Simon Commission. Simon is the name of a person. So who was this person? So who are the members of Simon Commission? Simon Commission was constituted under the leadership of Sir John Simon. So that's why this commission was known as Simon Commission, after his name only. He was the chairman. So Sir John was the in charge or head of the Simon Commission. Why was he sent to India? To look into the functioning of the constitutional system of India and suggest changes. See, elections were taking place, governments were being formed in Legislative Council and Imperial Council. It means some sort of constitution was already operating, though there was not a formal constitution, but there were some laws based on which British were governing India. So now this commission, the official purpose of this commission was to help better constitutional framework of India. And for that, they had come to talk to people of India. They wanted to talk to different political parties. It consisted of 4 conservative, 2 Labourites. Labourites means belonging to Labour Party, and 1 liberal member from British Parliament. Liberal means what? Supporter of Indian freedom. That's why he is liberal. So you can see this constituted of 7 members. So very important questions asked many a times. How many members were there in Simon Commission? 7 members were there in Simon Commission. But the problem was they were all British. They were all pure Englishmen. So they had no experience or idea of how India functions, because they are all politicians who live in Britain. They are British politicians. They do not live in India. They are not governor generals or viceroys. They have no understanding of how India works. And these 7 people will now decide about the future constitution of India, because they have come to India to suggest constitutional, to create a constitutional system. So foreigners who have no idea about India will decide the future of India. So these 7 foreigners were to decide what constitutional changes India needs. So very big problem. 7 inexperienced people will decide the future of India. So that was not tolerable to Indian people. So the appointment of the all white, what do you mean by all white? Not a single Indian was included in the commission. So the appointment of the all white commission sparked off a wave of protest all over the country. So what was the official position of Congress? Because nobody was happy that not a single Indian. See, the problem was not that commission was coming. The problem was that commission did not have a single Indian in it. So what was the official position of Congress? The Congress annual session of 1927, you have to remember this. Whenever a major movement has to start, Congress does a meeting, takes decision, only then the movement is announced to public. As you have seen, as was the case with civil disobedience, non-cooperation movement. So first a meeting was conducted, then it was announced to public. So now Congress have to develop its official position. They have to discuss among themselves. So now they are having an annual session at Madras. This was happening in 1927. Simon was about to come to India. Simon have left London in December 1927 and he have reached India in February of 1928. So these people, the Congress, they knew very well that Simon Commission is coming to India. So the president at that session was M.A. Ansari. Muhammad Ansari was the president. So at this session, a resolution was passed asking the countrymen, asking the people of our country to boycott Simon Commission. Why was Simon Commission coming? They were coming to talk to people of India. I mean, not talk to people who are standing on road, but to visit different political party, different groups, and to have meetings with them. So Congress said that completely boycott this commission. Do not talk to them. Do not meet them. Do not give any importance to these people. If they do not, you know, if nobody meets Simon Commission, their purpose of visit will be defeated. So now you are ready to boycott Simon Commission, but there are other groups who want to see why is Simon Commission coming to India? To take feedback from Indians. So there were some groups who wanted to put their feedback before Simon Commission. So in December of 1927, a large number of Muslim leaders had met at Delhi at the Muslim League session. See, on one side, Congress was having its session. So Congress said that we will totally boycott. On the other hand, Muslim League is also holding its session. So what is Muslim League's stand? So Muslim League does not want to boycott Simon Commission. They want to talk to Simon Commission. They want to give their feedback and suggestions to Simon Commission. That's why they are having their meeting. So a large number of Muslim leaders had met at Delhi at the Muslim League session and evolved four proposals for Muslim demands to be incorporated in the draft constitution, because Simon Commission was coming to take suggestion for constitution. So Muslim League wanted to give suggestions. So these suggestions were in form of four proposals. So these proposals, which were given by Muslim League to Simon Commission, these proposals are given to Simon Commission. They were also accepted by Madras session of Congress, because Congress was having its session at Madras. So Congress said that we agree with what Muslim League people are saying. That means their demands are justified. So the demands which were raised by Muslim League for the benefit of Muslims also have the support of Congress. So these proposals or these demands came to be known as Delhi proposals. So question is, who gave Delhi proposal? Answer is Muslim League. To whom? To Simon Commission. So Muslim League have already come up with its set of demands. So now what will Congress do? They have already decided to boycott Simon Commission. So Lord Birkenhead, who was Lord Birkenhead? He was Secretary of State for India. Secretary of State means what? Britain is ruling India. So there is a governor general who lives in India and behaves like a prime minister. But there are also officers located in London who controls governor general. So the post was Secretary of State for India, and Lord Birkenhead was then the Secretary of State. So he challenged the Indians that you want to boycott Simon Commission. So if you are boycotting Simon Commission, do you have any alternative? So he challenged the Indian leaders to draft a constitution for India, which he basically meant to say that you Indians are not capable of coming to a common consensus. He knew that there are different political groups. There is Muslim League, there is Congress, there is Hindu Mahasabha, there are communists. So Lord Birkenhead told that you Indians are not capable of coming to the same conclusion. You will keep on fighting amongst yourself. So that's why we have sent Simon Commission. So he told Congress that why are you boycotting Simon Commission? So if you are boycotting Simon Commission, can you come up with a constitution on your own? Can you decide jointly, take joint decisions? So Congress accepted this challenge at an all parties conference meet in February 1928, because constitution have to be framed with discussion from all the political parties. So Congress called a meeting of all these political parties, Muslim League, Hindu Mahasabha, Communist, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar's party. So every party met there and appointed a committee under the chairmanship of Motilal Nehru. Nehru report means Motilal Nehru, not Jawaharlal Nehru, to draft a constitution, because they wanted to show to the Britishers that we Indians are not incapable. Even we can come to a consensus without fighting, and we also can frame a constitution of our own. So all these political parties, they decided that let's make a constitution. And for that, the committee was formed. And who was the in charge of the committee? Motilal Nehru. That's why this is known as Nehru Report. So this was the first major attempt by the Indians to draft a constitutional framework for the country. So you understand the significance of this approach. It is the first time that people of India have come together and they are attempting to develop a constitution for their own country. First time this is happening. Before this, always Britishers used to decide. Always Britishers used to make laws. The committee also included Tej Bahadur Shapru and Subhas Chandra Bose. So Subhas Chandra Bose and Tej Bahadur Shapru both were tall Congress leaders. The report was finalized by August of 1928. So what was this report all about? So this report was basically a framework of constitution, what Indian people wanted. So framework of constitution prepared by a committee which was headed by Dr. Motilal Nehru. So what was the report saying? What were the demands put in that report? So Nehru committee, or you can say Motilal Nehru committee, recommended the dominion status. What is dominion status? So British Empire, they are ruling over many other countries, Sri Lanka, India, Canada, Australia. So all these units, all these are units of British Empire. So dominion status basically means giving full freedom to the unit so that they can frame their own constitution. They can become prime minister, president, but they will still remain under British control. So that was the concept of dominion. So Nehru committee at that time, they did not demand full freedom. They said that we are okay with dominion status. So the demand put forward was dominion status as the basis of constitution. That means based on the concept of dominion, that means India is agreeing to become a dominion. Now let's form the constitution. While a section of it wanted complete independence, people like Subhas Chandra Bose and Jawaharlal Nehru, who was Motilal Nehru's son. So father was asking dominion status, son was asking complete independence. So Jawaharlal Nehru and Subhas Chandra Bose, they were close friends that time, and both wanted that let's not demand dominion status, let's demand complete independence. So this report that was submitted to the government was not given any importance, because Simon Commission had already started. Simon Commission was about to reach India. So British government did not give any importance to Nehru report. So now the boycott begins. The commission arrived in India on 3rd February 1928. Date is not important, but of course you have to remember year. Simon landed in India in 1928. On that day, the entire country observed a Hartal. So that is the meaning of boycott. Wherever Simon used to go, people used to close their shops, streets were empty. So whom is Simon going to meet? Whom is Simon going to talk? Meetings were held all over the country calling for a boycott. That means Congress had taken the lead. that let's completely boycott Simon. There were firings at demonstrators in Madras and lathi charges at many places. So that is how boycott began. The commission faced massive protest demonstration and hartals wherever it went. The Central Legislative Assembly, in today's term you can say the Lok Sabha, of that time. So Central Legislative Assembly decided by a majority that it would have nothing to do with the commission. Why? Because many Indians were also there. So these Indians, they were in majority. So they decided by a majority that they are not going to deal or they are not going to interact with the Simon Commission. All over the country, the cry of Simon go back was raised. Simon, you go back. We don't want to talk to you. So very important fact, when the commission was on a visit to Lahore, Lala Lajpat Rai took out a peaceful rally to boycott, to make him realize that you are not welcome here. So Lala Lajpat Rai was a tall Congress leader of Punjab region and Lahore was part of Punjab only. So he was taking out a peaceful rally. He was severely assaulted by the police. He died because of his injuries. So Lala Lajpat Rai died due to lathi charge of police. He was a tall Congress leader. So entire country was stunned. So Lala Lajpat Rai's, entire world has heard about Bhagat Singh. So Bhagat Singh was a disciple, a close follower of Lala Lajpat Rai. So that day itself, Bhagat Singh had taken a vow that I am going to take revenge for Lala Lajpat Rai's death. And a few months later, he murdered a British policeman thinking that he is the same policeman who had done the lathi charge on Lala Lajpat Rai. But he was some other policeman. We will discuss that when we are reading the life history of Bhagat Singh. So anyways, so during the boycott Simon mission, which Congress stalwart was, you can say, killed or murdered by the British lathi charge? Lala Lajpat Rai. So Congress was stunned that such a tall leader was brutally killed by the lathi charge. So now Congress became all the more angry. So now Congress hardens its stand. In December 1928, please remember Simon Commission has already come to India in February 1928. Wherever it is going, it is facing boycotts. So in December of 1928, the Congress met at Calcutta under the presidency of Motilal Nehru, because Motilal Nehru had taken the lead. He had developed the Nehru report. So that time Congress was, you can say, under the influence of Motilal Nehru. Jawaharlal Nehru and Subhash Chandra Bose pressed the Congress to demand complete independence. What did the Nehru report demand? Nehru report had demanded dominion status. So father Motilal Nehru demanded dominion status. Son Jawaharlal Nehru and his friend Subhash Chandra Bose, they wanted complete independence. The Congress, however, passed a resolution demanding dominion status. So Congress knew that Britishers would never agree for complete independence. So they said that let's do not hurry. Let's do not demand too much. So the official Congress demand was the same as the demand of Motilal Nehru. Motilal Nehru was the president. So official demand was dominion status. This meant less than complete independence, obviously. But it was declared that if dominion status was not granted within 1 year, So Congress is telling the British people, we do not want complete independence, just give us dominion status. So we are making some concession, but you also promise that you are going to give us dominion status within 1 year. And if you do not give us the dominion status within 1 year, then Congress would demand complete independence. Fine. So we will again increase our demands if you do not agree, or if you do not actually grant us dominion status within 1 year, and we would then launch a mass movement to achieve it. So finally, the Britishers neither agreed for dominion status nor for giving complete independence. And finally, the Congress were forced to launch a mass movement. So this mass movement became known as civil disobedience movement. We will see that later on. So Simon Commission had come to India to meet various political groups, various sections of the society, but people were boycotting Simon. But there was one group which wanted to meet Simon Commission, because this group was very weak. It belonged to the poorest section of the society, the depressed class. So depressed class, their condition was not good at that time. Depressed class, they were facing large scale discrimination. So the leader of this group was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. So B.R. Ambedkar thought that it's not a good decision to boycott Simon Commission, because Simon Commission has come to India to take the feedback of Indian people. So it's not good to boycott him. So Dr. B.R. Ambedkar met the Simon Commission and he put two major demands before them. So Ambedkar made two demands. So which leader met with the Simon Commission? This question I've been asked many times. So four options will be given. Three will be from Congress. One will be Ambedkar. So Ambedkar had met Simon Commission. So what did Ambedkar demand? So he demanded universal adult franchisee. What is meant by universal adult franchisee? Anyone who is an adult, that means anyone who has crossed a particular age, is considered to be adult. So every adult must be given the right to vote, because during those times, not every Indian had the right to vote. Only those Indians who were paying taxes, who were educated, they were shortlisted by the British. Only then they were allowed to vote. But now Ambedkar warned that we do not want any criteria. You just give universal adult franchise. Why? Because the people belonging to depressed class, they were neither that much educated nor they were rich, neither they were paying taxes. So in fact, you can say that these people were not having the right to vote at all. That's why Ambedkar demanded for universal adult franchisee. Also, he demanded reservation in assemblies for depressed classes. Muslims and Anglo-Indians were already getting this reservation. So now Ambedkar said that if you are giving reservations to Muslims and Anglo-Indians, you have to give this reservation to us also, because we are the weakest section of the society. So yes, Ambedkar met Simon Commission. So what was the effect of this meeting? In its final report published in 1930, the Simon Commission rejected the demand for universal adult franchisee. This demand was rejected, but the second demand was accepted. That means, just like Muslims and Anglo-Indians, depressed class were also given reservation in the state and central assemblies. So you can see that Congress is totally, you know, boycotting it. Muslim League has already proposed, made Delhi proposals. Now Dr. B.R. Ambedkar had also had negotiations with Simon Commission regarding the depressed classes. So on 2nd November 1929, a conference of prominent national leaders issued a Delhi manifesto, which demanded, because now they are discussing, now they are putting their demands before the commission. So all the political parties came together, their prominent leaders, they came together and issued some demands. So that is known as Delhi Manifesto. What were those demands? That the purpose of round table conference should be about implementation of the Dominion status and constituent assembly. Actually, what had happened is that the Governor General at that time had promised that once Simon goes back, we will have round table conferences with Indian politicians. Round table conferences, RTC. So these leaders knew that very soon round table conferences are about to begin. So now they are putting their demand that, okay, you are promising that you are going to have round table conference, but the purpose of those round table conference should be about implementation of a dominion status and a constituent assembly. So before you call that round table conference, you first promise that the purpose of calling this conference would be to discuss dominion status. Don't give us lollipop, just give us concrete promises. The next demand was that the Congress should have majority representation at the roundtable conferences, because there were many other political groups as well. There was Muslim League, there was Hindu Mahasabha, there were communist parties. So Congress told the Governor General that, or Viceroy, that Congress should be in majority in these meetings known as roundtable conferences. Amnesty for the political leaders who were in jail. Because of boycotting Simon, many Congress leaders have been arrested and put into jail. So now these leaders want that all such leaders should be released from jail. So they are coming forward to talk. The Simon chapter is already over. The reports are already getting formed, discussions is already going on. Now things have proceeded beyond that. Now entire focus is on roundtable conferences, which is about to be held. So now negotiations is going about that conference. Viceroy Irwin promised a roundtable conference. So he promised that, okay, I agree that once Simon Commission submits its report, I agree that I will call a round table conference. When Simon Commission submitted its report, it was to discuss that report. So that was the purpose of round table conference. But he rejected these demands in December 1929. He said, okay, I will call round table conferences, but these demands that you want me to accept is not acceptable to me. All I can tell you is that yes, I will be having these conferences, but I do not accept your conditions. So now what will Congress do? What will these political parties do? The Viceroy is not ready to accept their conditions. That means still it is not clear. Still the Britishers are not in a position. They do not want to promise dominion status to India. The stage of confrontation, which is known as civil disobedience, was to begin now. So the stage of confrontation, because the Viceroy is not ready to accept their demands. They want the dominion status, but Viceroy is not promising them. So now they are ready to begin a mass movement, and this mass movement was known as civil disobedience movement. We will see. So now Congress have understood that these people are not going to listen to us. The Viceroy is not going to listen to us. So we will have to start a mass movement. So before starting that mass movement, Congress have its annual session, INC, Indian National Congress. So that session was held in 1929. Please remember, Simon had come into 1928. He was roaming visiting different countries, different parts of the countries for 14-15 months. So now the year is 1929. Simon has submitted its report. Congress have understood that Viceroy Lord Irwin is not going to give us dominion status. We have to start a agitation. So now they are having their meeting at Lahore. So what are they discussing in that meeting? Let's see. At the Lahore session of the Congress, the historic declaration of Purna Swaraj. Purna Swaraj means complete freedom. because they have told the Britishers earlier that if you do not give us dominion status within 1 year, our demand would change to complete freedom. So earlier they were demanding dominion status. The Britishers did not agree. So now they said that if you will not give us dominion status, then we will take even better. If our demand will grow even bigger. Now we want complete freedom. So this is a very important question. The demand for Purn Swaraj was made by the Congress for the first time at the Lahore session in 1929. Before that, they were happy with dominion status, but Britishers did not give them dominion status. So they got very angry. In 1929, they increased their demand. So from today, their goal is complete independence. First time it was declared at Lahore session. The flag of Indian independence was unfurled on the banks of River Ravi. So Lahore is situated on the banks of River Ravi on 31st of December 1929, eve of New Year. So this flag was hurled by Jawaharlal Nehru, Motilal Nehru's son. On Gandhiji's insistence, because Gandhiji liked Jawaharlal Nehru very much. Why did he like Jawaharlal Nehru very much? Because Jawaharlal Nehru have, you know, contributed too much in boycotting Simon. So when boycott of Simon was going on, Jawaharlal Nehru had played a very pivotal role. So Gandhiji was impressed by Jawaharlal Nehru. Gandhiji was impressed with Jawahar's contribution in Simon boycott. So that's why in the Lahore session of 1929, who was the president? Jawaharlal Nehru was the president. The flag was unfurled by Jawaharlal Nehru. Now the Congress says, give us full freedom, complete independence. We don't want dominion status anymore. On 26th January 1930, the Purn Swaraj pledge was taken by Indians. So in this Lahore session, Congress demanded from the people of India that on coming 26th this January 1930, because this declaration was made on 31st December 1929, the next day was New Year. The date changed to 1930. So they told Indians that after 27 days, that means on 26th of January 1930, let's come together, let's celebrate Purn Swaraj Day. So it was the first Independence Day celebration was done on 26th January 1930, even before India actually became independent. It was symbolic. So Independence Day was celebrated all over India on 26th of January 1930. Because of this date, 26th January, later on was adopted as the Republic Day. Republic Day. Actually, it was the Independence Day of India from 1930 to 1947. Every year people used to celebrate this to remember the declaration of Purn Swaraj. So the Lahore session was used to chalk out a plan for civil disobedience, because now it was very clear that Congress was about to launch a mass movement. So in this session itself, the plans for that mass movement was discussed. So that mass movement became known as civil disobedience movement. So you can see civil disobedience movement. Gandhiji gave an ultimatum to Viceroy Irwin saying 11 points demand have been ignored. So Gandhiji have written a letter to Lord Irwin. So in that letter he had demanded 11 things, but his demands were turned down. Lord Irwin did not agree to any of his demand. So Gandhiji said that we have no other option. Now Congress is left with no other option other than starting a mass movement. Mass movement means civil disobedient movement. So you will see because of these circumstances, civil disobedience movement was started. So, what happened to the final report of Simon Commission? The Simon Commission published a 2-volume report in May 1930. You won't believe, but even this question has been asked, that when was Simon Commission report published? People generally answer 1928. No, he was visiting entire India for 1 year. So in 1929, his visit ended and next year he published his report. It proposed the abolition of diarchy and establishment of representative government in the provinces, which should be given autonomy. So what was diarchy? There was a government in province and then there was a central government. So some things were taken care by at provincial government, like agriculture, sales tax, building of road, but some portfolios were taken care by central government, like defense, railways. So two sets of government was there. So what did Simon Commission basically said, that you make the center weak. See what was happening when Simon Commission has visited India, in Indians were becoming united. So the purpose of Simon Commission was to give more power to provincial governments. So if power is given to provincial government, the center becomes weak. Center becomes weak means the unity of nation is broken and regional powers get created, regional powers. So that was the purpose, that it is said that regionalism is the antidote, of nationalism. So nationalism means you are concerned about your nation as a whole. Regionalism means you are only bothered about your province. So that was the purpose of Simon Commission, that abolish diarchy and establish representative government in provinces. That means make provincial governments more powerful so that central level politics become weak. The number of members of provincial legislative councils should be increased. So that is how they plan to make provincial government more strong. Increased number of seats. The Governor General was to have complete power to appoint the members of the cabinet. It also recommended the separate communal electorates be retained. Separate communal electorates means some reservations, some seats were reserved where only Muslims will fight elections and only Muslims will vote. Some seats were reserved where only people belonging to depressed caste classes will fight election and only people from depressed classes can vote. So that was known as the system of communal electorate, based on which religion you follow. Simon Commission was doing this. So since Ambedkar had met Simon Commission, so finally Ambedkar's demand was met. Depressed classes were given separate electorate. The second demand of Ambedkar was not met. There was no universal franchise. It recommended that Sindh should be separated from Bombay, Burma should be separated from India because it was not a natural part of the Indian subcontinent. So this was the final report submitted by Simon. So what was the impact of Simon Commission? The outcome of Simon Commission was the Government of India Act. So Simon has submitted a report. So based on that report, the British government brought an act, Government of India Act. So it was basically constitution. This was practically speaking the new constitution. It is the basis of many parts of the present day Indian constitution. Our constitution today has 70% written material from here only. So what was Government of India Act? It was the constitution. Effectively, practically speaking, it was the constitution. And even today, our constitution is 70% based on Government of India Act. In 1937, the first elections were held in provinces. Now new constitution has come, new electorates were formed, reservations were given. So after coming of this new constitution, first time the elections were held. So these elections were held in 1937, resulting in Congress governments being returned in almost all provinces. So now Congress is winning in provinces. So this was the impact. Now Clement Attlee, he was one of the members, one of the seven members of Simon Commission. So later, since he was very sympathetic, towards Indian, because he has visited India, he has talked to so many people, he had come to know about problems of India. So from then on, he became very sympathetic. He wanted to help India attain freedom. So he was deeply moved by his experience on the commission and became the British leader most sympathetic to Indian independence. Later on, Clement Attlee became the British Prime Minister, and it is very interesting to note that this sympathetic person was the Prime Minister of India in 1947 at the time when India gained independence. So he did not create much hurdles because he was sympathetic towards India. So this was the story of Simon Commission and how the Indian struggle moved forward.